Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 7.7 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abacus. To simulate linear viscoelasticity of orthotropic materials, we program the constitutive equations into AUMAT, available on my website. See example 7.4 in the textbook to learn how to calculate the viscoelastic properties of the lamina in terms of the properties of the fiber and matrix. In this example, we use the viscoelastic properties of the lamina to simulate a viscoelastic laminate. First, we set the work directory to hold all the files for this example. Next, we open example 7.6, to recycle and reuse most of the model saved there. Then, save it as example 7.7. In module property, delete the material from the previous example, and create a user material to feed properties to the UMAT. This UMAT requires 10 properties, that are listed in table 7.5 in the textbook, as follows: 2 axial moduli, 2 Poisson's ratios, 2 shear moduli, and 4 relaxation times. This UMAT uses 6 state variables, called dependent variables in Abacus, which have to be declared here, so that Abacus reserves and keeps those variables throughout the simulation time. Now edit the section, to update the material assigned to it. For a relaxation test, we need to apply the displacement quickly, on step 1. Step 2 remains as in the previous example. Now let's adjust the field output requests, to save the results we need. Don't forget to include the state variables, SDV, because they contain values of moduli versus time, which you may need later. And the same for the history output requests. Here is the UMAT, and here is the variable that holds the SDVs. Scrolling down to the bottom, we can see the definition of the SDVs. In this code, the state variables are used to store the values of modulus as a function of time. Now we mesh. Now we create job 4. In tab general, you must link to the user subroutine file. To calculate the modulus EX, of the laminate, We need the resultant of the reaction forces, RF. For that, in the field output toolbox, we select symbol, RF, resultant. Now we pick RF in the history output. And we save it. It is saved internally, not to a file. And we plot, reaction force versus time. Edit. Copy, and paste to Excel. And plot in Excel. Okay, that's it for today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook, by following the link in the description. Thank you.